Hey everyone, it's me, the Otaku Fangirl, here to review the first episode of Ruby, Volume 5. So, they made it! Yeah, they are there, and I believe the place is called Mistral, correct me if I'm wrong, but yeah, the whole Ruby gang and Crow, they made it, and they get to have a conversation with the headmaster, Lionheart, which, if I remember from Volume 4, he actually has connections to, Cinder's group, so yeah, he can't be trusted, but the things they go over is basically a giant information dump. Yeah, we get all this information, just kind of, here, all have all this greatness, and I'm like, thank you. yeah, so the information that we learned that's pretty much the most important is that, well, Yang's mom, Raven, has the Spring Maiden, or at least that's what Crow, thinks. That's his, that's just what he thinks, and I'm like, okay. And Crow obviously wants to go and get her now, get it all done, but Lionheart, it's like, no, I need to convince the council because they have more problems to worry about than these just bandits, you know? So it's just like, okay, I guess we'll sit around on our butts for a while while we wait for this guy to whatever. It's like, come on, let's just go. Let's just get this done. But with Blake, she is still back home in Menagerie and not doing much. I honestly think the White Fang are gonna do something pretty big in Menagerie. That's why, Irina, I think her name is, the chameleon girl, who is also voiced by Jeremy Lee. I listen to her voice a lot more, now, and I'm like, yeah, that's definitely her, because I remember watching Volume 4, and I was like, she sounds like her, but I'm not 100% sure. But anyway, she was warning Blake, you know, you need to get out of here before something, and I'm like, probably the White Fang wanting to do some big scale something or other. So I'm like, and she doesn't want Blake to get in the way and get hurt and stuff, probably is what it is. But with Yang, finally more Yang screen time, because she hardly had any in Volume 4, but she is actually looking for her mom, and I'm like, oh, okay, I thought she was gonna go join up with Ruby. I thought that was her plan. I guess not. there was this hilarious scene, though, where she goes to this, like, gas station slash bar, I guess. And there's this guy who's, like, probably completely drunk, and he's, like, hitting on her, and then she just punches the heck out of him, and he goes, like, across the room, like, boop, 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 boop. That was hilarious. I was like, oh my gosh, Yang. I'm so glad Yang's, like, finally back in action and is actually doing something, not just sitting around, like, oh, my arm, I lost it. I'm glad she's actually, you know, gonna come back into this and gonna start fighting, hopefully, and hopefully join back up with Ruby, please, like, you know what, that's probably what's gonna happen, because Crow and Ruby and the gang are probably gonna go after Raven very soon, and maybe Yang will, they'll do it at the same time, and then they'll all meet back up, and most likely their plan to get the Spring Maiden's probably gonna fail. I'm like, they'll probably see the Spring Maiden, and then something's gonna happen, and Raven and Spring Maiden are probably gonna get away, and then Yang and Ruby and all of them gonna join back forces and be great time, except they lost the Spring Maiden. So yeah, but, that's probably what's gonna happen, I just have a feeling. But, yeah, at the end of this episode, though, we have, well, Ozpin's back! Kind of. He's just in another person's body. He's in Oscar's body. And he shows up. Oscar's like, hi, yeah, so I'm Ozpin. Or at least he's inside of me. His soul is, basically. And Crow's like, I did it! He was super drunk, and I'm just like, also, I liked Ruby coming out like, get up, girl! Just read comics in peace! I just loved that part. It was great. But, yeah, so they now have Oscar with them, slash Ozpin. How he's going to be useful, I don't know. Not sure about that, but we'll have to see. Maybe they'll teach Oscar how to fight, and it'll be great. Maybe. I don't know. But overall, this first episode was pretty good. Also, the new opening, it's really good. Way better than Volume 4's opening. I mean, it's not the best, but it's certainly better than Volume 4's opening song. Like, that one was pretty great. And especially the end part, like, visually, where you see, what was that big evil lady's name with the white-ish hair and, like, the white skin? I forgot her name, but you see her, like, there at the very end of the song, like, oh no, is she gonna show up? Is she gonna be the final boss of this, this volume? That's gonna be great. But anyway, what do you guys think of this episode? What do you think's gonna happen next? And I'll see you guys in whatever I review next. Bye!